Hi loves, welcome back to our channel. This is Jerry from Dreamy Craft Shop, and for today's video I'm going to be giving my Nintendo 3DS XL a Kawaii Rilakkuma makeover. These are the items that I chose for this makeover, so let's go ahead and get into it. This is the pouch that I have my 3DS XL in right now. I haven't used it in a few months, but I want to start using it again, so I decided that it'd be a perfect time to like bring it out and give it a makeover because it's just been put away for months. So I've been using this pouch for it, and I really don't like it. To be honest, I got this from Amazon, and in the picture it was like a really pretty pink, but when it came it was this, I don't know, this color, and I don't really like it. But that's why we're giving it a custom makeover today, so we won't have to be using this pouch anymore. So the 3DS I have is the 3DS XL. I believe it's the regular, not the new. And it came in this pretty pink color. So it's pink in the top and the bottom. So it's right there, Nintendo 3DS XL. And when you open it, it's like white on the inside. But mine is really like dirty because I haven't used it in a while and I haven't been playing it. So I'm gonna, before I start with any of this, I'm gonna start by cleaning it. So I'm just gonna use some like regular wet wipes, just like regular water wipes. Nothing like disinfecting or special or anything, just the regular wet ones. And then I'm just gonna wipe the whole surface just to get all this like dust and stuff off of it. I'm gonna do the back too, and I'm also gonna do the inside because the whole thing is kind of dusty. So this one, I actually got it as a trade with somebody. I had the 3DS in pink. It was like a metallic-y, pearly pink. And I really wanted to upgrade to the 3DS XL because I like the idea of the bigger screen. So I ended up trading someone on Instagram to get this one. Wow, it's like a lot dirtier than I thought it was. All right, now that it's all cleaned up, I'm just gonna go ahead and put it aside to let the screen dry. And also, I'm not gonna be putting a skin on mine because it's already pink and I really like this color. But if you wanted to put a skin on yours and you didn't have a pink one or a white one, I'll put a link in the description for where you can get a pretty pink skin from Sticky Bunny, and they do a skin for the top, the bottom, and even in here around this area. I was thinking of maybe getting a pink skin from them to put in here. I don't know, let me know what you guys think and I'll get one and show it to you guys. But yeah, I'm just gonna put this aside to dry, probably over here. And okay, so I have a few items out, so I think first what I'm gonna do is pick which items we wanna use for this customization, because I have like Rilakkuma and Rilakkuma versions of things, but the only case that I have is a Rilakkuma case, and I got this one on Amazon. I'll try to put a link for you guys. I don't have the packaging anymore, but it's just like a clear case with this Rilakkuma print on it. And I don't have a Rilakkuma version, so I think I'm gonna try to stick with, if you don't know the difference, Rilakkuma is this brown bear, and Rilakkuma, she's this cream colored bear. So I think I'm gonna stick with the Rilakkuma things and put the Rilakkuma things aside. So like for instance, I have these stylus, so it fits the 3DS LL, and one is a Rilakkuma head and one is a Rilakkuma. So I think I'm gonna put this aside and open up the Rilakkuma stylus. Oh, and as far as where I got them, I believe I had got this one on eBay a while ago, and I'll try to find links for these things for you guys, but I'm not sure if I'll be able to. And this one I got on a Japanese auction site, which is basically a site where you'll go and you bid on things that are in Japanese auctions, like Japanese Yahoo and Japanese eBay, but you can't bid on those sites if you're from America. So this third-party company will bid for you and then collect all of your items and then ship them to you. So I was on a third-party auction site and I got this Rilakkuma one from there. So I'll try to find them for you guys. Yeah, so I'm gonna be using this one, and I think they're so cute. I don't know if you can tell, their little head like sticks out of the 3DS, and I think that's so cute. So I'm gonna go with this one. so this is the stylus. Look at the cute little face. I wish I could make it like, okay, so yeah. So if you're unfamiliar with what a stylus is for the 3DS, it's so that you can touch the touch screen areas without having to use your fingers. And the screen is pretty dry now, it looks good. I'm gonna go ahead and close the device, and then I'll show you how to switch the stylus out. The stylus is right here on the side of the device. It's this white one, and usually you just kind of pull up and your stylus will come out. So I'm gonna be replacing this white one with this new Rilakkuma one. Let's compare them really quick. So this one's a lot longer, which is kind of nice. It'll fit in your hand better than like this little tiny one would for writing and stuff. But I think it collapses. Yeah, it collapses like that so that it'll fit in the 3DS. So I'm just gonna go ahead and put my white one aside and see. This should just slide in like this. All right, look how cute. Now we have a cute little Rilakkuma sticking out of our 3DS. All right, I'm so happy with that, that's so cute. So I think the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and put the hard case on the device. So I'm gonna be using this one that I told you guys I got on Amazon, I believe. And I'll try to link it for you guys if I can still find it. And I like these kind of snap-on cases because they literally just snap on like that. And now your device is protected, which I think is really cool. And it has this cute Rilakkuma design, so I think it goes really well with the pink switch because you can see the pink through it, but it's still protected. And I really like that about it. And the bottom is just clear and it just says, Rilakkuma, won't you live in ease every day? And you just snap that in place like that. And there you go, it's protected and you can still see the pretty pink color underneath. So I really like that. Okay, next thing we're gonna be doing to customize our device is the game card holder. So I was using this game card holder, or my twin sister was, for her 3DS, her new 3DS. So we have a few of our games in here, but I do have a few other games kind of on the side over here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna switch the games out and put them in this one to show you guys how they fit. So this is a game card holder and it carries 12 games in it. And it's a Nintendo official Rilakkuma. This is the Rilakkuma version. And I don't exactly remember where I got these, but I will try to link them for you guys if I can find them again. So I'm gonna go ahead and open this one. And I think it's so cute that there's a Rilakkuma and a Rilakkuma, and they're different colors. It's like so adorable, and the back is like their little butt, their little tail. I think that's so cute. So okay, when you open it up, you just open it up like this, and then there's this area here for 6 games, and you flip it, and then you can put 6 games here. And I usually like to decorate the inside of mine to kind of match the theme that I'm going with. So I'm gonna first pop some games in here and then use some stickers to decorate it. So first things first, I want to take the games out of here, and they're pretty easy to take out. You kind of just pop them out, I believe, from this side, like that. So I'll just make a little pile of games here. Oh, I always do that. All right, so now that we're done with this, and I'm just gonna go ahead and put her aside. And then I do have a pile of games over here. Just a few of the games that I like to play. We've got Frozen, Travel Adventures, Hello Kitty Party, Yoshi's New Island, Yoshi Island DS, Zelda, Castlevania. I haven't started this one yet. Super Mario Maker 3DS, and then Pokemon Moon, Diamond, a few different Pokemon games. So I think I'm just gonna go with the discs that are here so I don't have to pull any out, just to show you guys really quickly because it's the same all the way around. So right here there's like a glossy little graphic that shows you how the game should be put in. So you see that little notch there, it's represented there. So you want to put the game in like this, and the arrows show to put it in like this, and then snap it in like so. So So it's pretty easy to put in. These are DS games, and these are 3DS, but it does fit the 3DS and the DS games. I'm gonna put the DS on the back just so that I don't get confused and I know that 3DS are here and DS are here. So now that it's all in there, I'm gonna go ahead and decorate the inside. And I chose these stickers because they're like the most simple Rilakkuma. They don't have too much of a theme, and that's kind of like all these items are just Rilakkuma's face and body. So I thought these were a good idea. I'm just gonna use my tweezers and I'm gonna pick a couple of stickers to stick inside here. I think I'm gonna go with one big one on the back on this side and then a couple smaller ones on that side. So I'm gonna go with this huge one right here. And I really love it. It's Rilakkuma and she's like holding her favorite toys, and she has this Rilakkuma plushie and then her penguin plushie and her remote control chicky toy. It's like this little chicken and it's remote control. If you've seen her show or watched any of her cartoons and stuff, these are her favorite little toys. So I'm gonna stick her in the back right here with her toys. So cute. And I'm just gonna use my finger and press down. Okay, see that there's a little air bubble, so I'm just gonna kind of peel it up and hold it up, and then I'm gonna like kind of squeegee it down with my finger in hopes that I won't get air bubbles if I do it this way. Okay, I think that helped a lot. There are a couple tiny little air bubbles that you can see, but I think it's really cute and I think it looks really good, so I'm happy with that sticker choice. Now the front, let's pick a couple of stickers. I want to use Rilakkuma. I think I'm going to use this one because it's really cute and it's Rilakkuma and Kuratori, and they're getting all cuddled and squished in between Kuratori. And Kuratori is the little chick right there. That's their little friend. So I'm going to use that one. And I think the background color of the sticker goes well with the case. So I'm going to use that one right here. And then actually, you know what? My silicone tool is right here. I'm gonna use this silicone tool, and it's just a nail tool with that's like silicone at the end. And I'm gonna use that to kind of rub the sticker down to get any air bubbles out of it. I'm gonna pick more stickers. I think I'm going to use this one where they're eating like a little Dango says I love, I don't know if you can see it, says I love Dango right there, and they're eating a little Dango. So I think I'm gonna get that one. And if you don't know what a Dango is, it's this little like treat from Japan, and I'm not even quite sure what it is. If you know, please comment. I think they're like sweet rice or something, I don't know. They're kind of sweet. I've had them before and they're good. I think that's looking so cute already. So I think I might just leave that one like that. And then I'm gonna pick some other stickers for the inside of the switch. Actually, you know what? I'm just gonna put one just regular Rilakkuma head right here. And one Rilakkuma head. Right here. Just to kind of balance it. And I think that looks really cute. So I think that's enough for the game. I'm really happy with that. I think it's so cute. And I'm just gonna go ahead and put that one aside. And now I'm going to put some stickers on the inside of the Switch. Since it's just white here, and it, like when you're playing it, you don't get a lot of Rilakkuma vibes from it. So I'm gonna put some cute little stickers. Now I have this sheet of little itty bitty tiny tiny stickers. So I'm gonna try to incorporate some of these. And then maybe some of the small stickers from here as well. I really, really love this Rilakkuma with the Rilakkuma hat and the little Rilakkuma teddy. I think that's so cute. So I'm definitely gonna use that one. And then I like the ones with the pink border because the it'll come out pink on the switch. So which other pink border one is cute? For maybe here or here. Maybe these, like just their faces. So I'm gonna pick this little guy first. Okay, we got the sticky side now. So I'm gonna stick this one right here. And then I'm going to get this really cool one. And I'm gonna put this one right here. And then lastly, this just created from a face. And I'm gonna put her here. Yeah. Then I'm gonna get the little tiny ones for up there. And I'm gonna get the Kurila Kuma one. And I'm gonna put that one, I'm thinking right up here. And then I'm gonna get one of the laying Rilakkumas, I think. Like this one where he's, this one's cute, he's all lazy, but I like this one where it looks like he's kind of sleeping. And I'm gonna put that one over here. And that's already like looking so cute. So I think next, maybe I'll put a couple here. I think I'm gonna use some of these squares. I'm gonna use this square and this square and put those there. That's not very straight. And then this square. Oh, that's where the baby button is. Maybe here. I think I'm happy with that. It has cute little stickers and a nice little Rilakkuma theme to it now. So cute. Alright, now that that's all decorated, I'm gonna go ahead and put the stickers aside. And I think the next thing I want to do is put charms on it because I love putting charms on my devices. Now the cool thing about 3DSs is that they usually have this little area right here where you can go ahead and hook your own straps into. So I'm gonna be using that instead of on this one. I used it on one of my last switch customizations, and with those they don't have an area to put charms, so I have to use this like dust plug thing. So in this one we're not gonna be using the dust plug, so I'm gonna go ahead and take this off. And since it has that this little area here, you can use a strap like this, or you can use a ball chain like this. And I think with this one I want to use Rilakkuma instead of the Kurilakkuma because I want to keep the same Rilakkuma feel. And I like using these on most of my customizations for devices because the back of the head is actually a screen cleaner, so it works really well to clean your screen up. I'll show you. And I will link this in the description. I've linked it in past videos where I've used it, but I'll link it again in this video for you guys. And like, I don't know if you could tell, I had like watermarks on it from the wipe, and this just gets all of that off. Yeah, so I really like this guy. So I'm gonna show you how to put it on. First, you wanna take the strap off of the bear because you can't really do it with the bear on there. You'll see why in a second if you don't know how to do this. And you just want to like pinch the end like this and stick it into this area and kind of push through to try to get it to come out on the other side. So I have mine pushed through like that and it's not coming through easily, so I'm gonna grab a pointed tweezer And I'm gonna pull the string out. And I'm just gonna like go like this and kind of hook it and pull it through. Just like that. And once you have it pulled through, you open up the hoop and pull the clasp through. And that makes like a knot and ties it on there like that. And now you can attach the charm that you have. If it was a small charm that fits through here, then you can keep it on. But since this is a kind of big charm, you have to take it off before you do this. So now I have this cute Rilakkuma charm hanging from my 3DS, and I really like that. Yay! So I'm super happy with that. I think with this one, I'm just gonna keep it simple because the 3DS XL itself is kind of heavy already, and I'm just gonna keep the screen cleaner charm on there, just like this. All right, now that that's done, actually I have one more charm that I wanted to show you guys that I thought was kind of neat that I got the other day. And it's this Rilakkuma charm here, and I'll try to link it for you guys. And like you can see in the graphic here, you attach it this way, and this guy has a little lobster clasp, and he's made for if you want to put your like SD card or your one game in here. Or even if you have something small that you just wanted to take with you or store with you, then you can use this. Okay, I got it out of the packaging, and this is what it looks like. It's super cute. It's like a kind of leathery fabric, and it says Rilakkuma on the back, and it's got stitching on the ears and the face, and this is the zipper. That is so cute. On the inside, it's white with blue polka dots. Like if you have a Rilakkuma plush from Japan, you know that in the back his zipper usually opens, and his stuffing inside is the same material, white with the blue dots. So I think that's super cute. So yeah, and here you can put anything small you have, like an SD card or a game you want to take with you, or anything small you might have. And I'm gonna put this one on the device the same way that I put the plush on it. So first we'll have to unhook it. And we'll put this through the slot in the 3DS. Okay, so I'm pushing it through, and it's kind of coming through now, like that. So you're gonna pull this out, and then pull this through to make like a knot like that. Okay, so we got it through like that. Now that it's through, we can get the little Rilakkuma bag and hook that right back up. And now we have two cute charms hanging from the 3DS. You've got the little pouch and the screen cleaner plushie charm. And I'm really happy with that. I think it's super cute, and I'm excited to use it like this. So now that we have the charms on, I guess only thing left to do is put it away. So I was looking for a while for like a Rilakkuma themed 3DS XL case, and unfortunately I couldn't find any for sale. I saw pictures of some that they made like 10 years ago or so, but I couldn't find any for sale. So I did have this makeup bag that's Rilakkuma and Rilakkuma like strawberries and rabbits, and it fits in here. So I figured I'm just gonna start using this as a bag for my 3DS, since I never use it as a makeup bag because I have so many of them. So yeah, so it's really cute. It's like plasticky print on top, and then on the background you see this like pink satin. And I think I got this on a site like Depop or something like that, but I'll try to put a link if I can find one or something similar. And on the inside it's like really cute pink with white polka dots. So I'm just gonna put my switch in here, and it's roomy enough that I don't actually have to take my charms off to fit the switch in there. It fits in there pretty good, which I like. And there's room in here if you want to add anything. If you want to take maybe a game thing with you, you can fit that in this second pouch. And then it zips up pretty nicely. And if you wanted to, you could attach like a wrist strap or something else there. But I think I'll just keep it like this. And yeah, I think that's all for my custom Rilakkuma makeover on my 3DS XL. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to leave a thumbs up and subscribe, and please share the video with anyone that you think might like it or might be interested in a 3DS makeover of their own. Thank you guys so much for all the love and support. See you in the next one. Kitty and Jerry.